personally have seen the shield up close, and even I must admit, I am not impressed.
With a man whose leg I snapped oh so easily on my first night in WWE, your so-called architect, Seth Rollins.
I am not impressed with a man who's done everything in his power to avoid me, that human cockroach, Dean Ambrose. And I damn sure am not impressed with a man who I put to sleep time after time in this ring, the big dog, Roman Reigns.
This is a very anti-Roman crowd here tonight.
So later on tonight, I have myself a match with Dean Ambrose, but I've come out here for one reason. And it's to finish what I started with you, Roman, and I've come to finish it right now. And Roman, don't get it twisted. I'm not asking for you and your two lapdogs. No, 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 no. I want just you.
Weird shot of Seth.
You hear this, Pop? Go get Roman.
Where you at, big dog?
Yeah, go get the big
dog. They want you out here!
Huh? Oh. I
can understand the hesitation. I'm told that I am a very intimidating individual, and I know I'm a dominating one, just like I dominated him last week.
Dean's gonna go out there, guaranteed.
When I clutched you up and choked you down, you remember that, Roman?
Instead of getting early.
That spit was flying off your lip, and that fire, it started to fade in your eyes. I remember it all too well. You should consider yourself lucky, because if it wasn't for that silly bastard, Jason Jordan, I would have eaten you off this planet. And Roman, you know who wasn't lucky? Your compatriots, Seth and Dean, because if it wasn't for me, they'd be tag team champions, and they're not because of me. They would have made the Shield a grand stable of Imperial champions, and they are not because of me, and there is nothing you can do about it.
He has a point.
Oh, Roman, I made you succumb to my will. I punked you out. And you know what, Roman? If you got a problem with what I have to say, if you really got a problem, you'll come out here. Let's face it. I don't need anybody. I don't need Cesaro. I don't need Sheamus. I don't care about Dean. I don't care about Seth. No, 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 no. My name is Samoa Joe. I'm a man who stands on my own 2 feet. And let's face it, Roman, if it wasn't for the Shield, you would be nothing. Hey, and if you got a problem with that, feel free to come on down here and prove me wrong. I got this, boys. Tick tock, let's go!
So Samoa Joe has challenged Roman Reigns to come down to the ring and prove him wrong, that Roman Reigns can stand on his own 2 feet and doesn't need the backup of the remainder of the Shield.
I'm just gonna wait and see how long it takes to see if they come out. Is he not listening to that? Hopefully, no one gets his ass beat.
Joe, and I'll brawl here on Raw. Joe just trying to get away. It's must-see TV right now. Cesaro and
Sheamus. Did not expect.
So much for Samoa Joe not needing anybody as the clutch is locked in. A brawl outside the ring, but Roman's in trouble. Roman's in trouble.
Roman's about to go to sleep, Cole.
What do you mean about this?
Samoa Joe, damage done to Reigns. Look at that. To take care of Ambrose. And now Sheamus from behind. And now Rollins. Rollins trying to help Reigns, who's out.
The great strategy by Joe in the bar. Divide the shield and conquer.
Now the 3-on-1 attack. Oh, man.
Wow.
And Dean Ambrose, look at the fight at Dean.
You just don't know when to quit, dude.
Trying to crawl back into the fight for his fallen brethren.
He goes in down, he will go.
You guys mentioned it. It's pretty clear this was a
cool opening, man.